the best ways to prove that the codes, the Bible code, the Torah code, are true, when you see clearly that what is happening with the codes is far away from being coincidence. And one of the examples is what you see now. There is a number 1820, the 3,300-year-old secret. About this number, lot of material in www.1820.co.il. First of all, look into it, because it is something which is unbelievable. So many explanations about this number and how it fits in the Torah. 1820 time God name in the Torah. 1820 Gematria of Bereshit, Genesis, 1820 verses after the beginning of the new month. So, and many, many others. So this is called the secret number. And on this number, many things came out. And what you are going to see now, tables which have to do with redemption, with Messiah, with Israel, based on this number, which really far away from being coincidence. So let us still start. Here is in English, in order that you will understand. What you see is the following. You see here Messiah, Messiah, parallel, which is very significant, we said. Again, Messiah skip. Then you have parallel, redemption, as we said, redemption. Parallel, very significant. You have this year, 779. You have the word here, Geulah, redemption, and redemption twice, interesting. Then you have condition that you will have Messiah, that will have redemption is repentance coming here, and you shall observe my Shabbos, this is what God says. Keeping the Sabbath, keeping purity of life, this is. Now, so what you see here, very significant table, and as we see it now in Hebrew, you will see that really all this table based on number 1820. So this is in Hebrew, this table basically, which also Messiah, Messiah, again Messiah, keep my Sabbath, redemption, repentance, 5779. So what really you have here? As you see here on top, you have 9:10. What is 9:10? 9:10 is half on 80:20. Now the question why? Because you see here the word 5779. Letter after letter, it comes in 18:20. But what happens with Messiah? You can see there is a line in between. It means that basically from this letter, Messiah, Mem Tushin is 18:20. But in order that you will see other words in the same table, so the line was cut into two, so there is line in between. So because it is line in between, it is really 9:10. But basically the distance between letter to letter, Messiah and so on, is 18:20. So Messiah 18:20 three times, you have Messiah parallel, very significant, can be coincidence. And then you have a third one. So we said many times that Abba Kessin said there is three Messiahs. Messiah, the son of Joseph, son of Jesse, and Messiah who helps Israel. It was Cyrus at that time and Trump in this time. So, as we said, amazingly, you have the basis of 1820, you have coming of these words. Now let us see more 1820. Now these are really straight. Because here you see 1820, and you have here 5779, this year open for Mashiach, amazing. Best meeting of Messiah 5779, we should be very happy, but what we should do again, the word Teshuvah, the Shin, is the Shin of Israel. Teshuvah comes here, and again the condition which we saw in many other places, and we see, Shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat, let Israel keep the Shabbat, let keep the Sabbath, to do the Sabbath. For all generations, Brit Olam, it is eternal covenant between me and you, God says, between the children of Israel. Or it is a sign forever, eternal sign. What we see, you have Lapid today, you have Lieberman, you have others. leftists who are doing everything against this, desecrating the Shabbos, desecrating the holiness of family life, and so on. No. How can you have Messiah when the Torah says clearly? But as we said many times, the Maimonides, the Rambam said, according to the Torah, Talmud, that Israel will be redeemed only by repentance. Repentance is the Shabbos, everything. And if they will not, God promised they will do. So who knows? It can be because of a threat of war, like in the Sixth War, we don't know. But clearly come here, 1820, the secret number, 5779, Messiah, Tshuva, keeping the Shabbos. Exactly like the previous ones, right? Also, you have Shabbos here, you repent us. Exactly. Now let us see another one. And you have another one here, something very interesting. It's a sentence. Professor Ips found it. Yom Shabbat Tishmeru, Tishmor, speaking to the Jewish people. It's written in the word Israel, the children of Israel, yeah? They have to keep the Sabbath. Yeah, it is a sign for the Jewish people, Israel. So when Israel comes here, and let us see what more is about. Here, by the way, is the word Shuvu, return. Right? I didn't do it, but Shuvu, return. And exactly is written the word Yom Shabbat Ishmo. Very interesting, such a long sentence, and exactly 1820 can be coincidence. It's only once in the Torah, and the once is 1820. Sheshet Yamim Tasem Elacha. This is the verse of the Torah. In Exodus, 6 days, you should do work, but on the seventh day, Shabbat Shabbaton, Kodesh, Sabbath Shabbaton is holy. Then if you will keep the Sabbath, which is equal to Kol Mitzvot Hashem, our Rabbi said that keeping the Shabbath is like keeping the whole Torah, because it's the basis of faith of God. And again, parallel Messiah, then you will have Messiah. Fits with the idea before also that keeping the Sabbath is brings Messiah. Another one, this is another one really is not so clear, but this is what we did you about. But here also, here you have Israel. Israel, yeah, every 1820. You see, 1820, Israel. Yeah. It's not something you can find easily. So is it Israel here as Messiah, definitely. And also as the other places, Bayom HaShvi'i, Sabbath, Kodesh, Holy. Then comes here a very interesting idea, which is the verse. We mentioned very interesting. There is a verse which is speaking about redemption. It's the Igalenu, Redimas, Redimas. And then it's written, Dodo, when Dodo, as his cousin or the uncle will read it. But in Hebrew, Dodo should be with the letter Vav. Now it is written without Dalet, Dalet, Vav, exactly like David. So our Rebbe said that really uncle and cousin represent David and son of David, yeah, son of Jesse, but amazing. And this is exactly the verse we said, Yigalenu, redeem us. Gaol, surely redeem us. But only in condition, the Torah Shmor, that you should keep the Torah. And as we said, the seventh day Shabbos you should keep. So altogether, very interesting table. Again, 1820, Israel in this number, see completely another story. The others were Messiah, every 1820 of 5779, but here another, in fact, this is much clearer. You can see here clearly Israel. This case you have Israel with this year, 5779, and small ship of repentance. Amazing. That message to Israel, if you repent, you do repentance, then you will have redemption. Then we have Messiah. You have Messiah twice. Messiah Hashem, Messiah Hashem, Messiah of God. Son of Joseph, and son of David. Amazing. Again, 1820 Israel. So it can be coincidence when you have Israel, you have this year, and you have twice Messiah, and small skip of Tshuva and redemption. Definitely, anybody with common sense. But unfortunately, as I see when people speak, react to tables, you know, without knowing what is a table, immediately, they don't like, It's funny, you know, how people today, I don't know what to call them, silly or blocked. They don't look at all what a table calls. They make comments without nothing. This is frightening. How can people live about it? It's frightening when people live without thinking. So let us hope that people will think properly and will realize that what we see here it is a clear proof to the Bible code, to the Torah code, because to have this also in Moby Dick, it's definitely nonsense. So, important, significant table, as we said, about this number 1820. So it's very, very much recommended that you will go into this site, www.1820.co.il. You will see wonders, simple wonders that is unbelievable. A rabbi more than 100 years ago said this. So important, significant table. Watch each one properly, and immediately you can realize that it's far away from being coincidence. And all this teaches you, you should teach Israel, but you know that Satan is very strong, especially before the time of Messiah. This is really the opposition now in Israel to religion, you know. Lieberman suddenly comes with such incitement, you know, it's frightening, something which never ever such a thing. This is a Satan. The Satan is worried that Jews will do tshuva and Messiah will come. They will have to keep the Torah, and it's difficult to keep the Torah, the Shabbat. They want to go out on Shabbat to the sea, they want to enjoy themselves, yeah. But the time will come, no doubt, because the Torah says the Jews will do tshuva, will repent. Who knows if it's not because of what is now developing with Iran. So it's better to do tshuva before, because after all, the great question, if the repentance will accept it. Because one should do tshuva and it is still free will. So, interesting table, important table, and again, recommended to look into the site of 1820. And you will see wonders, so important, significant tables as you saw.